and Wayne Duncan first played together in Sons of the Beautiful Mother, making avant-garde rock in the outrageous. It was at one of the Sons' gigs at a theatre in Cornell, South Australia, according to Daddy Cool's trusty roadie Scrooge, that tonight's inductees actually heard live. When the support act cancelled, they raided the theatre's cupboards, found some fox ears for Ross and some other crazy threads, and came on stage as the Fourpence to rip the place apart.
Hello everyone, HD Nelson here. I'm delighted, no more than delighted. I'm proud and humbled to be here at the Victorian Music Awards, ushering into the Hall of Fame, Daddy Cool. Of course, Daddy Cool, the hits, one after the other, top 10, no better than that, number one hits around the world, and it's a travesty that they're not already in the Hall of Fame. Of course, whenever Daddy Cool played, the years fall away, and all of a sudden you're 47, 48, or 49 all over again. Having said that, can I say the Hall of Fame comes with responsibilities? And I'm glad to say that, unlike other bludgers in the Hall of Fame, Daddy Cool are prepared to sit in the hall there on Russell Crescent, North Fitzroy, every weekday afternoon between 3 and 5, answering letters, emails, tweets, and encouraging everybody to get involved in the world of rock. It's a tremendous innovation that Daddy Cool will be there, really there, in the Hall of Fame. Congratulations, Cool. Carry on, everybody.
Crazy vocal range and understated bouncy shuffle swing was irresistible. Visually, they were cartoons. A boogie marathon with Hannah walking on the end tops and Gary Young shooting water pistols at the front row.
G'day everyone, Murray Cook from the Wiggles here. Congratulations to Daddy Cool on their induction to the H Music Victoria Hall of Fame. It's fantastic news. I was 11 years old when Eagle Rock came out and went to number one, and it had a huge impact on me. I just loved the sound, the look of the band, you know, the wonderful voice of Ross Wilson, the swing and rhythm section of Wayne Duncan and Gary Young, and of course, as a guitar player, I bow down to Hannah, the great Ross Hannaford. So it's really exciting that this is happening, and they really had a big impact on me as an 11-year-old, just getting into rock and roll, and just really showed me that Australian music was as good as anything around the world, and so good on you guys, thanks for that. About 32 years later, I had the great fortune of recording a version of Eagle Rock with the Wiggles and Ross Wilson, and it was just amazing, one of the great thrills of my life, sitting next to Ross. He's playing that iconic riff, I'm playing the bass guitar. It was fantastic. So congratulations, I can't think of a band that deserves this more. They're a great Melbourne band, a great Australian band, just a great band, the mighty Daddy Cool. Good on you guys.
This band that I absolutely love. So I'm talking about pre-Sherbert, pre-Skulls, pre-ACDC, pre-JPY, Squid, and Dan Coleman. And we're Daddy Cool.
Hey, this is Ben Montez from Cowboys and Heartbreakers, and there's raucous noise all around me as everybody's so excited to know that Daddy Cool is in the Hall of Fame, in the H Hall of Fame. I love Daddy Cool. Daddy Cool means a lot to me. I'm going to play and come back again and go to every arrangement and shows that I've been doing. I plan to record it. I just want to say, how many goddamn is it wonderful? God bless you all.
Their debut single topped GoSet's national chart for 10 weeks from May 71. Eagle Rock was Australia's first original gold single by a rocker. 50,000 copies were sold. Meanwhile, the album Daddy Cool sold 60,000 and then 100,000 copies, blazing its own record-breaking mark as the biggest selling original rock album. It would be followed by their lollipop EP and the second album, Sex, Dope and Rock and Roll Teenage Heaven, in early 72, sprouting high in the The members of Daddy Cool recorded the final hurrah of sorts at the Much More Ballroom in August 1972. Released in 1973 as the provocative double-line album, The Last Drive-In Movie Show, and bowed out. But hey, they weren't about to let Daddy Cool go that easy. They've come back again for Sunbury 74, for the Boxing Day Tsunami Benefit, for Moomba, and we're cozy just to come back again. They're play with other bands still, and you know they'll never leave our airway.
Danny Cool to officially induct them into the Hall of Fame. One of Victorian music, no, Australian music, global music's most articulate voices. The one and only Brian Mancurvis.
Thank you, Henry Wagons! What about this? Is this right? I want to be, because that's where I was for the first set. How good is this room? How good is this night? That completely takes your breath away. And Jess Cornelius, Dear Prudence, and then we're loving Ed Nimmerville, and we're all here together, and we're inducting Daddy Cool! And they are loitering. You should see Hannah. What four guys, what a band. What a song catalogue. Come back again. Oh, Teenage Blues. I've been thinking a lot about getting a job, but I'm paranoid about my hair. I just left school and I don't mind saying I'm scared. Fucking great lyrics. Ross Wilson, come back again. Hi, honey, ho. Ba ba na. I mean, what a bad. Who'd love Daddy Cool? Who turned that microphone on? The fucking look at Wayne Duncan. Oh, look at him dressed up. That's the thing about this band. I could go on, but I shouldn't, because they're there and they're gonna play. But what a catalogue of songs at 3:40 today, driving down Dickens Street in Elwood with 3 12-year-olds going to cricket practice at Waddy Watson, and there's a lot of, you know, Cherry the radio, and he wants to hear 101 point whatever. And, but every now and again I smuggle a little something in, and they're mad for it, and Bomb Bomb goes on and the car goes off. Today at 3:45, going down Glen Huntley Road, this is an honour for me, and I'm not going to be too long. I do need to tell you that the first band I ever, or the first show I produced, I was the leader of the North Baldwin MYF. That stands for Methodist Youth Fellowship. It was 1972, and we'd had dances in our little church hall, and we'd had local bands, Axis Heat, just doing Axis Heat sort of stuff. And someone one night said, why don't we get Daddy Cool? And we all laughed at him. And then he said, no, why don't we get Daddy Cool? Gary Young lives in North Baldwin. Ross Hannaford is tall. Wayne Duncan owns a record store in Auburn Road. And I met a guy outside who said, yes. I walked in and Wayne said, can you look after the shop? And he was gone most of the day. But it was Wayne Duncan. So, we got them. And they played in 19, I think it was 72 or 73. And we were so excited because we were 17 and there was 100 kids in this little hall and they just rocked. And at the end of the night, I went up to Ross Wilson and I just said, Ross, that was so great. And I was such a fucking dag. And it was churchy, but we went into, you know, we were sort of left, but we were North Baldwin ultimately. And he just looked at me and he goes, man, we really dug it. And we just loved that. 2 years later, I went to my first Where the Fuck Are We ball for Monash University. We all had to go to the Caulfield Railway Station, and we all, 400 uni students, hopped on a train, and the windows were blacked out. It was called the Where the Fuck Are We ball. And the train went from Caulfield Station to Werribee, and we got off and we didn't know where we were or who we were, because there'd been a lot of whatever you did in 1974. And we walked up the main street of Werribee and we walked into the town hall and Daddy Cool were playing. And stop talking because that means they're not coming on. Ladies and gentlemen, you've got to make a bit of noise. I think we will bring them on in alphabetical order. And I know this band refuses to enter a stage in Melbourne in 2014 until the roof is raised. On bass guitar, ladies and gentlemen, Wayne Duncan! To spend the last five Sunday nights with a hero of mine. We did some shows years ago at the Universal Theatre, and seeing the Jim Key stuff and the Ed Nimmervoll stuff, and I saw a photo of Ross Hannaford this afternoon, and we spent time with Peter Jones and Stewie Speed and Linda Gibson, and they've gone. But I've been working with him for the last five Sunday nights. He's a champ. Look at him. Look at that guitar. Just looking like that, and he's looking like that here. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going alphabetical order, and I know he would approve of that. All right? XWY, the boss, a writer, a performer, a bloody champion, a man who has really injected something into Australian music with producing, with writing, with songs that just make us all jump for joy. Ross, the boss, Wilson!
It's so wonderful to be in the Hall of Fame, and we hear that if the Labor government gets in, they're actually going to build one. I'm hoping I'm going to start lobbying. I want a special room with, you know, all comforts and everything. Go there and you can come visit me, whatever. Yeah, because we're all going to need that pretty soon, I think. Music Victoria, I think, have asked us to enter into their research program of the effects of acid on music from the musicians of the 70s, so looking forward to that. They might have some good stuff there. Yeah. And wonderful to be in the Hall of Fame, and thanks for coming along tonight. Which you probably don't know, but you know. the matter. Because tonight's all about us. We like.
Oh, Yeah.
Danny Cooper's room. Peter Lucky Lusky on the drum. Monster Sound with Gary Young there. We're going to have a little cruiser now.
Ah, Get Christmas hurt, let the fun begin. suppose, with our love of R&B, and R&B without today is another kind of R&B. And one of the guys we love was this guy who wrote Louis. But he loves other good stuff too, Richard Berry. And we're going to play that song. We're playing this song. Yeah, Rich Berry. You might have noticed that Daddy Cool has lots of songs with the word daddy in it. It seemed to act at the time, and this is one of the songs that inspired us to write Daddy Cool. It's called Daddy Daddy. Thank you. man was me. Anyway, Donna, forgive me. I did meet a girl once called Donna, and she said, "You wrote that song about me." And I said, "No. Just made it up." Here's what it is. Ooh.
Paranoid.
Thank you. Yeah.
time inductees, Daddy
Mom.
word daddy, you know.
Daddy fix. It's a counter, right?
Down the street, she said, wow, what a square, don't you? Did you see? Daddy Cool, get out of the music machine. Daddy who?
Daddy Cool!
Daddy who?
Congratulations to all the winners this evening. Thanks again.